in this part. And after we had finished inputting the data and parameters for the sub-basins in the study area basin in the previous parts, we will continue conducting hydrologic modeling using the HEC-HMS program for the gridded option. And we arrive at outlet, at the outlet one, and in the sync menu there is description and downstream. Then in the options menu, we don't have the observed data, so we leave it as it is. Then we go to the WT or water treatment. And the rest of junctions in the study area basin. And we don't have observed data about these junctions except the junction that precedes the Dokang Dam, which is junction J308. And in it, we have the observed data. So we go to the options menu, then we can obtain the observed flow from the file on the desktop. Titled SWAT project, which was obtained from the previous video parts of category or playlist titled SWAT Professional. And in it, we have the daily discharges in the access file titled SWAT output.mdb, as we see, and in it we open the RCH table, and in it we have the flow out for the 7 sub-basins. And we need the flow out for the 4th sub-basin, so we make a left click on the sub-field, then we choose the sub-basin number 4, so we obtain the daily flow at Dokang Dam from 1 January 2003 to 31 July 2014. So we need the flow in or daily discharges at Dokang Dam, and to input these daily discharges into the project, we go to the project in the HEC-HMS program, and in it we go to the components menu. Then we choose Time Series Data Manager. In the data type, we choose Discharge Gauges. Then we press on the new. Then in the name, we type observed data. Then in the description, we type observed discharges. At Dokkan. Then we press on the create. Then we go to the time series data, then discharge gauge, then we choose observed data, then in the time series gauge menu, we specify the options, and in the time interval, we choose 1 day. Then we press on the gauge. Then in the time window, we specify the date and time according to the date and time of the observed data. Then we go to the table menu. Then we go to the access file that contains the daily discharges at Dokkan Dam, and we activate these daily discharges data in the flow in field. As we see, then we copy them, then we go to the project in HEC HMS program, and we paste, them in the table menu. Then the daily discharges data at Dokkan Dam is added to the project in the HEC HMS program, as we see. Then we return to the junction J308. Then we go to the options menu and in it, and in the observed flow, we choose observed data. Then we input the data and parameters into the reaches. So we go to the first reach R 510. Then in the reach menu, we specify the options, as we see. Then we go to the routing menu, and in the initial type we choose discharge equal inflow, and the values of the length and slope exist. Then for the mannings in, we can take it from the following table.
Table 5.2, value of manning in for floodplain from Thompson and Hajala Marsin 1991.
And it contains the following mannings in values as we see. In this project, we go to the pasture, no brush, and we choose short grass. Then the normal mannings in is 0.03. So we go, so in the mannings in, we type 0.03. Then in the space time method, there are three methods, and we choose auto dx auto dt. In the index method, we choose flow. In the index flow in meter cube per second, we choose its value according to the following explanation. The index method is used in conjunction with the physical properties of the channel and the previously mentioned space-time interval selection. The selected index method and specified parameter will be used by the program to discretize the routing reach in both space and time. Appropriate reference flow and serialities are dependent upon the physical properties of the channel as well as the event S in the question. Experience has shown that the reference flow or the serialty based upon average values of the hydrograph in question, i.e. midway between the base flow and the peak flow, is in general the most suitable choice. Reference flows or serialities based on the peak values tend to numerically accelerate to the wave much more than would be occur in the nature, while the converse is true if the low reference flow or serialty is used once 1983. So the index flow, i.e. midway between the base flow and the peak flow. And to obtain this mid flow for this project, we have the observed data at Dokkan Dam in the Excel file. Titled Observed Flow Data in Dokkan. And in it, we go to the observed data and we calculate the maximum discharge value and the minimum discharge value. Then the average of them is the index flow. As we see, then the index flow is 311.9 meter cube per second. So we copy it and we paste it in the index flow in the HEC HMS project. Then in the shape or the shape of the cross section for the flow channel, we choose rectangle. So we need the width in meter or the channel width. To find the channel width for this reach, we use the Google Earth program. So we will need the reach coordinates, and to obtain the reach coordinates in order to find the channel width, we go to the HEC GeoHMS project in the ArcMap that we prepared. In the previous parts of the category or playlist titled HEC GeoHMS, and in it we open the table of the river one layer. And in it we have the name of the reach in the name field. And to find the coordinates of the reach point at which the channel width will be calculated in the reach, we specify the centers of the water courses of the sub-basins in the study area basin. So we go to the search. And in the search, we type mean center. Then we make search, we make a search, then we press on the mean center tool. In the input feature class, we choose river 1. In the weight field, we choose river R. River length, R-I-V-E-L-E-N, or river length. In the case field, we choose name, and in the output feature class, we specify the save name in the following path. Desktop, LaserZap, LaserZap.gdb, then we type the name without space, which is mean center. Then save, then OK. Then close. Then the points at which the channel width will be calculated in the reach, which represent the centers of the water courses for the sub-basins in the study area basin, appear with the green color. And a new layer titled mean center appears. Then we open the table of this layer, and in it we have the UTM coordinates for the points. Then we specify the latitude and longitude coordinates for these points by going to the utility menu. Then we press on the add latitude, longitude, and the input point layer we choose mean center, then OK. Then close. Then we open the table of the mean center layer, and in it the latitude and longitude coordinates for these points at which the channel width will be calculated in the reach appear. Then for the first reach, which is R510, we specify and activate this reach inside the table. And the coordinates for this reach are in degrees, minutes, and seconds. So we transform them to the decimal degrees by using the calculator. As we see, Then we go to the Google Earth program. Then in the search field, we type the latitude and longitude coordinates for the central point for the first reach are 510, as we see. Then we press on the search. Then the point site at which the channel width will be calculated in the first reach are 510 appear. To measure the river or channel width, we press on the show ruler tool, then we choose the line and we specify the unit in meters. Then we make several measurements for the channel width around or near the central point, as we see. Then the channel width equals the average of these measurements, which is approximately 80 meters. So we go to the project in HEC HMS program, and in the width we type 80. Then in the Mannings N, we type 0.03. Then in the Index Flow Meter Cube Per Second, we type 311.9. Then we go to the loose over gain menu or method. And in it, to input the value of the rate in meter cube per second per 1000 meter square, we go to the PDF file. And in it, we read the following.
In HEC HMS, Transform lose data enter user lose gain method is the read tab for each routing reach, although major protection rate between the highly variable table 7.2 provides some guide for selecting their selection if using it my point cross section option table 7.2. Calculation rate for various channel bed material from SCS National Engineering Handbook Section 4, Chapter 17.
In this table, we have these values according to the bed material, transmission loose glass, and calculation rate. And here in the table, the bed materials that we have in the study area are between the sand and the gravel mixture with low silt clay content and sand and the gravel mixture with high silt clay content. So for the percolation rate, we choose 1 inch per hour or cubic feet per second per acre. So we need to convert this value to the meter cube per second per 1000 meters square. According to this relationship, to do so, we use the calculator, as we see. Then the value becomes 0.007 meter cube per second per 1000 meter square. So in the rate we type 0.007 and this value is used for the discharge correction. Then we go to the sediment menu. Then in the initial gradation curve we choose the gradation LZRB that we prepared in the previous part. In the erosion limit, we choose length depth ratio. In the deposition method, we choose effective depth. Then in the temperature method, we choose average. In the temperature, we type 13 and in the bed width we and whereas the channel shape is in the routing menu is a rectangle and the width is 80 meters, so we type 80 and the end depth in the bed depth in the bed depth we choose 5. Then the active layer factor is between 0 and 1, so we choose 1. Then we go to the options menu and in it we can enter the observed values, but we don't have observed values in this range. Are 510 and it is optional, so we leave it as it is. By that, we have finished inputting parameters and for the first reach are 510 and we will continue the implementation in the next part. Then we save the project. Then we save the project by pressing on save.